Hello student, welcome to biology class, and in this video lecture we will discuss about the disorders related to our circulatory system, which is the last topic of this chapter, that is body fluid and circulation. So here we will discuss some disorders related to our circulatory system, especially related to the blood and the heart. So the main and the first, which is the very common disorder on this at this time, it is the high blood pressure. Which is also known as hypertension. High blood pressure or hypertension, it is a common disease or disorder at this time related to our circulatory system. So what is the meaning of high blood pressure? It is the blood pressure is the condition of blood pressure more than 120 and 80, which is called high blood pressure, or it is the condition of high blood pressure. So here, what is the meaning of 120 and 80? It is in NMHG. So what do we call this indication, or the number indicate for which things related to our blood? So 120 mmHg, it is known as systolic pressure. Systolic pressure or pumping pressure. Systolic or pumping pressure known as the 120 mmHg, or it is the normal blood pressure which is responsible for systole or pumping of the heart. While 80 mmHg, it is known as diastolic or resting pressure. Resting pressure means when our heart contract, so during contraction, which is also known as systole, the blood pump, so that pressure is known as, also known as pumping pressure or systolic pressure. And after pumping or after contraction, the alternate stage is known as the relaxation or diastole, which is also known as resting pressure. So it is the normal range of blood pressure of our body. But the high blood pressure or hypertension appear as a symptom if the symptom we can say that internal symptom will be appear as regular checkup. Check of BP more 140, 90 or above. So that condition, this condition is known as which is 140, 90. It means if the systolic pressure becomes more than 140 in regular checkup, and diastolic pressure more than 50, that is 90, So in that situation, or that is the situation of hypertension or high blood pressure. So high blood pressure may affect our body. Or what are the things which may affect it? So effect of blood pressure appear on some organs of our body, such as hypertension. It damages our heart. It means heart problems created due to high blood pressure. It also affect vital organ of our body, such as kidney as well as brain. So in that condition, due to hypertension, there may be these are the organs. They may be affected by this disease. Now the second disorder related to our circulatory system, which is also very common, that is CAD, coronary artery disease. So CAD is a disease which is caused due to the insufficient supply, or which is caused due to the damage or blockage of the blood vessels that supply blood to our heart. And the blood vessels that supply blood to the heart, it is known as coronary artery. So this disorder, coronary artery disease, is also known as atherosclerosis. It is also known as atherosclerosis. So in this case, what is the reason or cause of the disease in the form of, the first is due to the blood vessels. The blood vessel supply blood to heart. The blood vessels which supply blood to the heart muscle, it is the one of the cause for coronary artery disease, because that blood vessels which supply blood to the heart is known as coronary artery. So on the basis of the name, coronary artery is disorder called as CAD. So what may be the main reason for the coronary artery to become unable to supply oxygen or nutrient to the heart muscle? So due to accumulation of some ions, some fat, cholesterol, or deposit of calcium ion, fat, cholesterol, etc. So these, due to deposition of these substances, the coronary artery becomes blocked. So in this case, or in this situation, our heart not work properly, and that is the condition known as CAD. Now the next disorder we will discuss about, the angina. Which is also known as also called angina pectoris. Angina pectoris. So in the case of angina pectoris, the condition it is also responsible for the less supply of the blood, and that less supply of blood, it is due to the our lungs. So the symptom in this case, symptom in the case of angina or angina pectoris, it is the acute chest pain. In the form of acute chest pain, it appears that is angina, and it is more common in middle age, and elderly people, the people that require middle age or elder, becomes elder, middle age and elderly. In that because the angina is a common disorder related to our circulatory system. Now next we will discuss about the other disorder, that is fourth disorder we will discuss about, heart failure. So heart failure is also known as, it is also known as congestive heart failure. It is also known as congestive heart failure. So it is known as congestive heart failure because the main reason for the heart failure is congestion of lungs. Due to congestion of lungs, the problems created is known as heart failure. If the congestion takes place in lungs, so there will be less amount of oxygen to becomes exchanged at the place of lungs, and that may result the insufficient supply of oxygen to our heart muscle. So the heart becomes able to pump efficiently. Means the symptom or internal symptom of the disease is in the form of the heart muscle not work efficiently. It means contraction of heart to not becomes efficient. So heart failure, there are some also disorder related to the heart. It is we also mention here as cardiac arrest. As in the case of heart failure, the heart pump the blood but not in inefficient way. But in the case of cardiac arrest, the cardiac arrest is the condition in which the heart stops to beat. Means heart beating becomes stop. So that condition is known as cardiac arrest. One other disorder also related to heart failure is related to the heart is हार्ट अटैक हार्ट अटैक इज द कंडीशन इन विच ड्यू टू लेस सप्लाई ऑफ ऑक्सीजन द हार्ट मसल गेट डैमेज So in that case, in the case of heart attack, the heart muscle get damaged due to less inadequate supply of oxygen. So these are the disorder which are very similar to each other, with and especially related to the heart. But here we have also discussed three cases, but these three cases are related to the blood vessels which are responsible for the circulation of blood throughout the body along with the heart. So blood hypertension, it is the case of blood pressure which is also known as BP. One thing we need to add, the instrument which is responsible or which is used to measure blood pressure, it is known as sphygmomanometer. So by using sphygmomanometer we can check the blood pressure. If the regular checkup found to be 140 to /90 or above, that condition is called hypertension. So this is all about the disorder of circulatory system.